This is the third video in my three-part series on marriage. In the first video, I had talked about compatibility in marriage. In the second video, I talked about personal space for women within marriage. And today, I talk about extramarital relationships. I'm Dr. J.E.G. I usually release content related to English language and literature. If you are a student or professor of English literature, please do subscribe to this channel. Today, I respond to a comment that I received on my Preface to Shakespeare video. In the video, I had talked about the extramarital relationships in Shakespeare's plays such as Antony and Cleopatra and Troilus and Cressida. I received a comment from Manoj Dinakaran saying that I have to talk about the need for morality in society. Now, one person cannot talk about the sexual morality of 8 billion people on the planet, but I can insist on wisdom in sexual relationships. So, what do I have to say about extramarital relationships? Here goes. Life is pain whether you are married, unmarried, or polyamorous. So, choose your lesser pain for the long run. Sexual attraction begins around teenage and it stays with us for most of our adult life. As we get into relationships, whether marriage or dating, we start realizing just how difficult relationships can be. That's when we break up or get divorced or enter into an extramarital relationship or decide to just hook up with whoever is available. There's no easy solution to this. Please do watch my first video on compatibility in marriage. If life is mostly pain, I give you a whole list of pain points to remind you to choose your lesser pain for the long run, be it marriage or staying unmarried or polyamory. I give you a list of emotional pain points, physical pain points, economic pain points, and social pain points. Emotional pain points. Do you need loyalty, companionship, or security and protection? How do you deal with jealousy, anger, and revenge in sexual relations? Physical pain points. How do you express your sexuality? Can you trust your partner not to physically abuse you? What about an unexpected pregnancy? Do you and your partner agree to contraception and abortion? What about STDs? Who will help you in your old age when your body grows old and senile? Economic pain points. Can you simultaneously manage a job and household chores? If you have children, how will you procure money for childcare? Social pain points. Will your primary partner accept you having other partners? Do you need approval from your family or society? Can you face ostracism from them? Can you face legal cases for unacceptable sexual behavior? In childcare, who will do the emotional labor of raising children? Who will be the adult male and female role models for children? Because children are the future of society and childcare is a very important social responsibility. Every one of these pain points is addressed to both men and women and not just any one of the genders, including the pain points of unexpected pregnancy, contraception, and abortion. So that was a whole list of pain points. They may have unwittingly been biased in favor of monogamy, but I'm sure it's exhaustive enough to remind you to choose your lesser pain. So what is your long-term lesser pain? Is it staying unmarried? Is it monogamy, or is it polyamory? But I get it. We live in a world of hundreds of distractions. Communication technology is exploding with Instagram and Facebook and WhatsApp and Zoom and Tinder. More women are entering the workspace and men and women are interacting much more than in the past. Though I'm married, I've gained immensely from my friendships with both men and women. Women for emotional support and men for perspectives that I just wouldn't get from my women friends. The boundaries between a monogamous marriage and an extramarital relationship can get difficult. But I have to remind myself that the freedom to talk to men after marriage is not available to many married Indian women, and that my husband trusts me and I trust him back. So I hope that these three videos help to shine a light on marriage and extramarital relationships and some kind of wisdom in our relationships. If you haven't watched my first two videos, please do watch them here and here.